Hey, what is up guys, 1360 here with a look at the Android 5.0.2 Lollipop update for the Verizon HTC One M7. The update is finally here, and Verizon rolled out this update after multiple delays on Thursday, May 14th, and although the update arrived 4 months after the 90-day guarantee set by HTC, it's still better late than ever. So if you're rocking an HTC One on Verizon, you can go into the Settings, System Updates, check New, and you should be prompted with a pop-up screen to update, and you'll have to install the first part before installing the second part. The process did take me about 2 hours, so make sure you have the time required to dedicate to the update. So let's get right into what is new as a result of this update. So of course, we have our lock screen notifications. So the Lollipop style lock screen is adopted with this update. Another change is within the notifications manual panel. As you can tell, we've got the sandwich style, where you swipe for notifications and swipe a second time for quick settings. Now, of course, you can see the material design elements in there as well. HTC did not include the flashlight function within the notifications, but they did include it in a separate flashlight app, which is this one right here, and you can adjust the brightness of the light, so a nice little touch. Another new addition is the recent apps, and the cart style format has been adopted, similar to Lollipop, and if you don't like it, you can change it back to the old grid style. Screen pinning is on board as well, and we can click on this pin to lock the app into place. The settings menu has a few new changes as well. Sound has been changed to sound and notifications, and with Lollipop you can manage your app notifications and decide which apps you want to block and which apps to prioritize. The search function has also been added for faster access. Android Beam, which is the option to share content with NFC, has been added with the update. And to take advantage of it, let's say I want to share this webpage, all you need to do is enable NFC and tap it with the device you want to share. The HTC Eye experience has also been added, and you can see it in the camera with new shooting modes like split capture and photo booth, so a few welcomed additions there. The update also included a file manager in case you didn't have one installed already, and that's really about it for specific features. Overall, I think it's a fantastic update. I've experienced no bugs or issues yet. Battery life is solid and pretty good, and so you should definitely install the update to take advantage of the latest features. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.